Welcome to the fifth part of the lecture on stoichiometric organometallics. Subject of today is the deprotonation of aryl CH bonds with organometallic bases. So, the prototype of an aromatic system is of course benzene. Benzene plus N-butyl lithium, N diethyl ether at room temperature, approximately 25 degrees. Well, there we have no reaction on a reasonable time scale. Same reaction conditions, but adding TMEDA, that's tetramethylethylenediamine. So this structure, in that case, it reacts smoothly, giving the lithiated benzene plus butane, of course. So, adding the TMEDA indeed makes a difference, and it changes the structure of butyl lithium aggregates, and at the same time then modifying its reactivity. So, the aggregation of butyl lithium, so N times butyl lithium, depends on the solvent and additional reagents. Oh well, better here. So, in hexane as the solvent, we have a hexamer, hexameric butyl lithium, so 6 butyl lithium units forming one aggregate. In diethyl ether, we have a tetramer. So the butyl lithium tetramer has well, a structure with lithium tetrahedrons. So, this is rather simple to draw. Just draw a cube and add 4 lithium atoms at these corners. The remaining corners are occupied by the butyl groups. And in addition, the lithium is coordinated by the oxygen of the ether molecules. This is the structure of the tetramer. In, well, you see, These four lithiums, 1, 2, 3, 4, could be regarded as forming the corners of a tetrahedron. Okay, so what would be the structure of that hexamer? There, the lithium atoms sit at the corner of an octahedron. Well, this is too complicated to draw, at least for me. So, in THF, we have an equilibrium of the tetramer and the dimer. And with adding TMEDA, we have then exclusively the dimer. The reactivity increases with breaking down those aggregates. The smaller the aggregate, the higher the reactivity in terms of basicity of the butyl lithium. In case of the dimer, coordinated by two equivalents of TMEDA, the structure looks like follows. Here we have a 4-center, 2-electron bond, we have a 4-center, 4-electron bond, and it's coordinated by this chelating ligand. Well, and of course the same here on that side. Well, if we have an additional substituent on the benzene, then very often the deprotonation will take place also to the substituent. Here in this case, it is fluorobenzene. We have already discussed this examples. This example, just to remind you of that. So with N-butyl lithium at minus 55 degrees in THF, it takes about 7 hours to deprotonate completely in ortho position. And if we increase the temperature above minus 50 degrees, then lithium fluoride is eliminated. And as you should remember, the arine, the dihydrobenzene, is formed. Highly reactive and undergoing some reactions, for instance, Diels-Alder reactions with a diene present. It might be present. So in general, if we have einen Benzenring with a functional group G symbolizes a functional group. Which can coordinate a lithium plus. So a functional group with a free electron pair. Well, the atom which bears the free electron must not free electron pair must not necessarily be directly bound here. It could be connected with a benzene ring by a tether. That's why I have drawn that this way. So, and with butyllithium, we will usually observe the ortholithiation. This is called the DOM reaction. And DOM is the abbreviation for directed orthometallation. Well, what's the mechanism? the best article about the mechanism you can find in Angewandte Chemistry, it's Angewandte Chemie, and it's an article, it's written in German. Well, 104 1992, page 768. You should look it up if in Angewandte Chemie International Edition is the English translation of that. It's an article by Paul von Raak Schleyer. A famous chemist, both for theoretical chemistry and also for some marvelous examples in preparative chemistry. He, for instance, invented, to my knowledge, the famous adamantane synthesis. Okay. So. As you know, cyclopentadiene dimerizes to form this Diels-Alder product. Actually, you normally can't buy cyclopentadiene. You buy this dimer and you crack that dimer at above 180 degrees, maybe with some iron powder as a heterogeneous catalyst, and you have the oil bath at 180 degrees, and the head temperature will be at 40 degrees than with a boiling point of the cyclopentadiene. And you collect the cyclopentadiene while cooling it, of course, down to maybe minus 70 degrees, that the Diels-Alder reaction doesn't occur. Okay? So, this is the first step of the synthesis of Raak-Schleyer. Hydration. will give you this hydrocarbon. And then, under strongly Lewis acidic conditions, an isomerization takes place. Giving this hydrocarbon adamantane, which is the thermodynamically most stable isomers of all hydrocarbons with C10, and how many hydrogens do we have? With a molecular formula of C10H16. Okay, this is the most stable one. And Ragschleier anticipated that it should be possible under some harsh conditions to isomerize this to that. Okay, and it worked out just fine. And you see, this is so marvelous because, well, it is a tiny little part of the diamond structure, of course, hydrogenated on the surface. Well, okay, so, but back to the deprotonation. So in this study in Angewandte Chemie, the Ragschleier group reported that they have calculated with model compounds the DOM reaction. So, and in the first step, butyllithium will coordinate to that functional group G. The next step, the deprotonation takes place, and I will try to draw the transition state. So lithium coordinated to the functional group and still also coordinated to the carbon of the butyl group. So in the transition state, the lithium is coordinated to the functional group G, to the carbon of the butyl group, and at the same time to the carbon of ortho to that functional group connected by a tether with that aromatic system. Well, and of course, this is then the result. So, what is important with in that article? Ragschleier group claims that the complexation of the lithium in the transition state is more important than the precomplexation of the butyllithium just before the deprotonation starts. Because, well, this transition state has a lower activation barrier due to the complexation during the transition. And indeed, they noticed within their calculations that the lithium is more close during the to the group G during the deprotonation, during that transition state, than in the pre-coordination. So it is a kinetic effect because of the lower activation barrier. This is one very important, the most important factor. There are other factors. Well, okay, it is still a factor that if you have the lithium coordinated here at the group, then it is of course more close here to this CH group than in power position or somewhere. This has an influence. And another influence is, well, that if you have a positive polarization here at this position, this is normally the case if that function group G is directly bound to that carbon, because the functional group is a fluoride, an oxygen, and so on. Yeah. So, and then a delta minus at this position, then you have a delta plus the lithium, a delta plus the hydrogen, and well, a delta minus you had at the carbon, of course, because it is butyl lithium, and as a metallorganic reagent, the alpha carbon has is negatively polarized. So, and well, this setup with plus minus is also energetically favored, generally. Now to more examples of DOM reactions and the influence of several factors. Anisole. Anisole plus N-butyllithium forms a tetramer just as we know it from diethyl ether. Okay, so essentially, well, of course, anisole is also an ether. It reacts under deprotonation in ortho position at 25 degrees, but slowly. Okay, you have to wait for a few hours. But if you add TMEDA, well, okay, then it becomes a fast reaction, even at much lower temperatures. So what's the application? Of course, if you add an electrophile that symbolizes that as EX, then you will get the substituent selectively into the ortho position of the methoxy group. If you try this type of reaction just by electrophilic aromatic substitution, you get usually a mixture of ortho and para products. What could be EX? Alkyl halides, for instance, allylic bromides reacts very well, but other electrophiles can be, for instance, trimethylsilyl chloride, or well, okay, boronic acid ester, and well, an aldehyde or a ketone is of course also works very well. One 1,3-dimethoxybenzene. Our trivial name is veratrole. If you want to, well, introduce a halide, for instance, an iodide, well, by electrophilic aromatic substitution, then you would normally choose iodine, elemental iodine, and an oxidizing agent. Electron-rich aromatic system, electrophilic substitution will work just fine, but exclusively in this position. You have no chance to get the iodide in the position between those two methoxy groups. But if you methylate by deprotonation with N-butyl lithium, this works very well with a dimethoxy, 1,3-dimethoxybenzene, then you get selectively the lithiation between the two methoxy groups. And then at lower temperature, adding iodine, you will get this product in a rather good yield. Next example. Now we have two functional groups that both have the capability to complexate butyl lithium, to pre-complexate it, and also, of course, in the transition state. So, we have a selectivity problem with adding the lithium base. We could either get the lithiation ortho to the methoxy group, or of ortho to the dimethyl amino methyl group. If the lithium base is just N-butyl lithium in hexane, that means we have initially the hexameric butyl lithium, then we don't find any products which derive from this intermediary organolithium compound, but we can achieve by trapping the organolithium compound with those electrophiles about 80% yield of a product, well, with an electrophile sitting ortho, or the former electrophile, a group that has introduced as former electrophile ortho to the dimethyl amino methyl group. So how can we explain that? The hexameric butyllithium has a rather low reactivity. Its reactivity is not sufficient to deprotonate, at least at lower temperatures, ortho to a methoxy group, but the dimethyl amino methyl group already reminds us of the TMEDA. This is better coordinating to the butyllithium, already starting to break up the hexamer, and therefore the reaction, the deprotonation, takes place at this position. If we add TMEDA, then we will have the butyllithium dimer already highly reactive. So the pre-coordination is not are important than for the reactivity anymore. What is more important is then, well, this changing of delta minus and delta plus we have already discussed, and the stabilizing effect of the coordination during the transition state, and this then favors the lithiation ortho to the methoxy group, and we get then 55% to 7% approximately. Further directing groups. Some classical protecting groups do an excellent job in directing the lithiation. For instance, a MEM group, MEM protecting group, the abbreviation for methoxy methyl group, methoxy methyl group. So classical protecting group for alcohols and especially phenolates. The lithiation will take place in the ortho position. Next example, a carbamate, normally a diethyl carbamate. Also lithiation in the ortho position. Normally you apply secondaric butyllithium as the organometallic base, since it is sterically more demanding, and with N-butyllithium you would get more side product with a nucleophilic attack of a butyl group at the carbonyl group. So, and changing to secondary butyllithium prevents that to happen. And it's the same with oxazolines. also with secondary botulithium, you get the lithiation here in the ortho position. Well, first electrophile, then adding the electrophile. Secondly, hydrolyzation. You would get to an acid with the substituent in ortho position. Well, here you have, in principle, a protected carboxylic acid. Okay. So, and by electrophilic aromatic substitution, you have, of course, no chance to get a substituent ortho to the carboxylic acid, and the substituent was, derives from an electrophile. No chance to get that to the ortho position. Electrophilic aromatic substitution would always take place in the matter position. Next example. This turns out to be somewhat a limitation of the DOM reaction. If we try the ortho methylation with this substrate, it doesn't work. Instead, this is deprotonated in a more acidic benzylic position. With increasing temperature, this reactive intermediate is not stable and a 1-2 Wittig reaction will occur. Leading to this product. The mechanism is somewhat unusual for organometallic chemistry. Well, at least this is my impression. But to explain it. In the solvent cage, the lithiated in benzylic position lithiated compound in the equilibrium will also form the ion pair. Then an intramolecular SET process could occur, forming this anionic radical with the CH3 radical in close proximity. Well, this type of anionic radical is very well known for us from organic chemistry too. We call that ketyl radical. These are, for instance, important in the pinacol formation process as intermediates in the McMurray reaction. Also important as, blue-colored stuff when drying THF with sodium and having benzophenone in there, okay? Always ketyl radicals. So, and this is of course very short-lived in the solvent cage and will soon form the C-C bond and to the final product, then the alcohol after hydrolyzation. Another example, interesting example for the Wittig rearrangement starts with a slightly modified substrate, not with a methyl group, but with this allylic system. Again, butyllithium deprotonating with butyllithium. In this case, at somewhat higher temperatures, that 1,2 Wittig rearrangement will occur. And after hydrolysis, will lead to this product. We need somewhat elevated temperatures in organometallics. This might be zero degrees or room temperature to occur that. Well, the higher temperature because we break an oxygen carbon bond forming these radicals. But there is a concerted reaction pathway which can already occur at much lower temperature. This is then the 2,3 Wittig rearrangement. Concerted mechanism. These arrows explain what's going on. And after hydrolysis, we will get to this alcohol as the final product. No. One carbon too much here. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons in the side chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now it's correct. Okay. Well, back to the initial plan to use the methoxy-methyl group for the ortho methylation step that doesn't work due to the Wittig rearrangement. But if we simply start from the benzylic alcohol, the first equivalent will of butyllithium will of course deprotonate the alcohol. But with the alcoholate, the acidity of the benzylic position is diminished. Then, with Buhle TMEDA, we can achieve a second lithiation, this time then in the ortho position. Now to an interesting example, how to achieve, well, the introduction of a substituent ortho to an aldehyde, also making use of DOM-type reactions. In the first step, we add lithium morpholate. So actually, we would do that the other way around. We first would deprotonate dry morpholin, for instance in THF, with butyllithium, getting to the morpholate, and then adding one equivalent of the benzoic aldehyde. The lithium morpholate will add to the carbonyl group, giving rise to such a hemiaminal. Then, with N-butyl lithium, we have coordinating functional groups, yeah, here, nitrogen, oxygen, maybe already chelating the butyllithium, and in the ortho positions the deprotonation will take place. This is the most nucleophilic position. Therefore, with an electrophile, it should react here. But in case, for instance, with acylation with trimethyl silyl chloride, we would presumably add two equivalents. Well, and hydrolyzation would under very moderate conditions, then this is more stable than that. So would give us this is a final product. Deprotonation of heterocyclic systems. In this case, it's not a heterene, so not an aromatic system. Dihydropyran. Is methylated, lithiated at the alpha position. The same is true for various five-membered heterenes. Furans. Thiophenes and also pyroles, of course not with a pyrole that is not substituted at the nitrogen. So if you have an NH which is acidic there, the hydrogen sitting at the nitrogen is of course deprotonated. There is one exception. With a TMS group at the pyrrole, the nitrogen of a pyrrole, and using tertiary butyl lithium as the organometallic base, the lithium takes place in three position simply because of a steric hindrance between the TMS and the tertiary butyl group, and on the other hand, tertiary butyl lithium is much more basic than N-butyl lithium, and the basicity is already high enough to deprotonate already at positions with no ortho activating group. After those five-membered heterenes work very well, it's clear that we have to ask, what about pyridine as a six-membered heterene? Well, depending on the exact reaction conditions, you have a problem when trying to deprotonate pyridine with N-butyl lithium. A nucleophilic attack can occur adding the butyl group to the alpha position. Sometimes ago in my lab, we tried the reaction of picoline to methyl pyridine with tertiary butyl lithium, 5 equivalents. To obtain a 63% yield of this picoline attached or equipped with 2 tertiary butyl groups. Addition elimination process, lithium hydride is eliminated. This type of reaction should remind you of a name reaction. You, I'm sure, heard about that before because of its strange name, the Chichibabin reaction. For the Chichibabin reaction, pyridine reacts with sodium amide. Usually performed, this reaction is performed in liquid ammonia. Also, an addition elimination process and under the strongly basic reaction conditions the amino pyridine is, of course, then deprotonated. Nevertheless, the deprotonation of pyridine is not impossible. I found a preparative procedure in a very, very good book. The main author is Brandsma, Preparative Polar Organometallic Chemistry 1. All on page 175. So, what's described there on a 100 millimole scale is the synthesis of 4 iodopyridine. The first step, pyridine is treated in a THF hexane mixture at -100 degrees with a combination of N-butyl lithium and potassium t-butoxide. This combination is called an organometallic superbase. Very often called Schlosser base or Lochmann-Schlosser base. It's very basic, and you will have a mixture of all three possible potassium substituted pyridines, rather unselective. If you then add HMPT, well, I actually don't recommend using HMPT. HMPT, hexamethyl phosphoric acid triamide. This is the structure. It's a very well coordinating solvent or reagent, but at the same time highly toxic. A cancerogen. And well, before you ever try HMPT, one should first check if some other solvents give similar results that are far less toxic. For instance, this one here, DMPU. So this avoid whenever possible, to make that clear. So in Brandsma's book, well, it's done with HMPT. If I would try it, I would first try DMPU. So HMPT and a bit more pyridine, then going from minus 100 degrees to minus 80 degrees and waiting some time, and you will get selectively, with about 90% selectivity, the potassium in the 4 position. So this system is so reactive that it deprotonates wherever a proton is. Okay. Here it has then time. Well, this is all those potassium pyridines are themselves very basic. So they deprotonate pyridine at the higher temperature and give it some time, then you will get the most stable one. And it seems to be that the thermodynamically most stable one, the equilibrium. In equilibrium, this is 90% advantage, okay? Well, next step, and this makes the whole procedure a bit tedious, dry lithium bromide is added for a transmethylation. from the potassium transmethylation from the potassium pyridine to the lithium pyridine. Then iodine is added and you will get the iodopyridine. So now we can answer the question, why Brandsma recommends to perform that transmethylation, because the potassium pyridine is far more basic than the lithium pyridine, and if you form the iodopyridine, you already have again an ortho-directing group, and with the potassium pyridine present, he was afraid that the orthomethylation would be a competing reaction, a side reaction, and you will get less yield of the iodopyridine, which in this case is or was isolated with 50% pure yield after recrystallization. Okay, so it is as Brandsma emphasizes, preparatively the best way to synthesize this 4-iodopyridine in reasonable quantities. Another example of pyridine chemistry, this time with an additional functional group. So, DOM reaction at hydroxy 3-hydroxypyridine. Of course, we have to introduce a protecting group. Well, this is actually an example from Viktor Snikus' group. He is one of the main protagonists of the DOM reaction, working in this field for more than 30 years with marvelous examples. We will see some of them. Three-hydroxypyridine plus a reagent with a chloromethyl oxy group and a trimethylsilyl ethyl group. This is, well, its name is 2-trimethyl. Silyl ethoxy methyl chloride, and for the abbreviation chemists choose to take the S, the E, the M. So it is ZEM chloride, and it's the ZEM, S-E-M, protecting group. Works very well in presence of a base, and it's a protecting group for alcohols, especially also phenolates. This step gives more than 80% yield. N-butyllithium with diethyl ether at room temperature And secondly, trimethylsilyl chloride as electrophile. Gives selectively the TMS group in the 4 position. Again, yield about 80%. This is interesting since now we have blocked this position with the TMS group, and for the substitution, of course, the 2 position here is more interesting. Introducing, for instance, a hydroxymethyl group or something like that, yeah, that we have at the end coordinating functionalities, hydroxyl groups here, there, and here at the nitrogen. This is interesting then. Well, okay, this blocks the position, and the second deprotonation should then take place here in this position. So, what we need is a somewhat stronger base, tertiary butyl lithium, again in diethyl ether, minus 78 degrees. This is, of course, not isolated, a one-pot reaction. We can add for instance benzaldehyde and then hydrolysis under moderate conditions. We lead us to this intermediary product, and we can easily get rid of all the TMS groups. So this is again around 80% yield, good reaction. We can get rid of a TMS group with tetra-N-butyl ammonium fluoride applied in THF. And get to the final product, the last step with 90% yield. Maybe it's an interesting information, where do we get the hydroxypyridine, 3-hydroxypyridine from? It's not a natural product, but it is synthesized quite large scale from natural products in very few steps. Always you start with a pentose. It's not important with which one. With concentrated sulfuric acid, you can eliminate 3 equivalents of water. And you get to the furan 2-carboxaldehyde. Called furfural. a mass product. And with ammonia, under acidic conditions, more than 170 degrees, maybe some catalyst and some pressure, you will form the imine, and then a rearrangement will occur. Leading to the 3-hydroxypyridine. One last example of an interesting process making use of the DOM reaction, again from the lab of Viktor Snikus. The details you can find in Journal of American Chemical Society 1980, 102, and page 1457. They again start with a pyridine derivative. This nicotinic, oh no, it's not nicotinic acid because it's a 4 position, well, isonicotinic acid amide. First, with secondary butyllithium, the presence of TMEDA, THF, minus 78 degrees. Well, ortholithiation. Well, both positions are, of course, equivalent. The electrophile is added. An indole derivative, the 3-carboxaldehyde. Addition of the organolithium compound to the carbonyl group. Will give us this secondary alcoholate, lithium alcoholate. Into the same reaction flask, again, secondary butyllithium, TMEDA was added, well, same reaction conditions, minus 78 degrees. So now we can look for the most acidic proton, and it is this one, the 2 position of the indole system, alpha to the nitrogen here, and in close proximity to coordinating functional groups, this one and that one. probably maybe better this way. Well, the carbonyl group of this amide is sterically somewhat hindered. The secondary butyllithium didn't attack that carbonyl group intermolecularly. Now we have intramolecularly the nucleophilic aryl lithium in close proximity to that carbonyl group, and intramolecularly the addition of the aryl lithium to the carbonyl group will take place. Next step, hydrolysis. Here we have again a hemiaminol. It's hydrolyzed to the stage of a ketone. Here we have a secondary alcohol. And for the before the final purification of the compound, the chemists of the Sneekus group let it stir at air. For a while, and it is then oxidized to the paraquinone system. This paraquinone is isolated. With a 76% yield of this one pot process, starting from here. Very nice chemistry. The target molecule is an alkaloid. Called elliptisin, will take a few more steps. You have methyl groups here. This is then the final product. I think this nicely demonstrates all the power of DOM reactions. Well, was a long lesson today. I promise the lesson tomorrow will be a bit shorter. Tomorrow we will also talk about superbases, organometallic superbases, but mainly about the stability of organometallic bases under various conditions. Thank you for listening. See you tomorrow.